most people in America looking for how do I make a life worth living and a return worth having. The liars of America want to play with $2 like they've given you a million. And openly, they're trying to be gracious and kind. At the same time, they're trying to hand you food through a window, acting as if they're in power over you, as if they're feeding some sort of a pet. And I really don't know how to express this well enough to people. We are in a time of COVID. We are in a time of haranguement. We are in a time of a situation where people say, oh, I want to give a homeless man some food, and they might get it for free, and then it's really not free because it's old food. It's manipulated food. It is tainted food. It is ill-will food, and that does not put any human being in a good mood. I've also seen some loving kindness of an older gentleman who was black riding a really marvelous souped-up scooter. Almost looked like it could have been a Harley Davidson motorcycle, and then I looked at it again and saw it was a scooter. But he drove up to a guy who was completely getting sunburned, sitting out there looking for some help, and he gave him some food. And I was really happy to see that. I also wish that the number of people that drove by might have thought to go buy the guy an umbrella. Now then he'd have to be wise enough to continue to remember to bring it with him, but a golf umbrella can really help someone to stay out of the heat, especially if it's a light color, like a light tan or a white with some other color. You see, it's those things that we need to survive the heat if we've lost our home for whatever reason. Many people lose their homes today for a lot of reasons. They get behind in rent, they get behind in their life, they lose a job, they don't do things right. In my case, I was totally attacked by the liars of America. And the liars of America stole my property bags. They stole my bank cards. They stole my life insurance policies. They stole my religious items. They stole my heirlooms from my dad. They stole my belt buckles that were one of a kind. They stole my rings also that are hard to find. In life as in truth, those people were supposed to represent the law. They were sheriff of the Indianapolis Marion County area, and they stole it all. I'm missing my jeans that have angel wings in the back that normally would be $400 in the store. How I got them was God giving me the grace to find them, but someone still took them for me anyway. They took my JF shirts that were red and blue. They took other things too. I did leave some of my materials with an old reporter named Mike Ahern and his wife Sherry, who I happened to meet at a gas station. They decided to help me with, despite the fact that they alleged that they were practically homeless, but being helped by their synagogue, their church, because of her marvelous background. But I still haven't been able to get my things back from them. And it's been more than a year, and I've tried many times. You see, the liars of America always jump the gun, and the liars of America can ruin relationships. People love to ruin relationships for other people because they're jealous, they're immature, and they're insecure with the Lord's house. You see, the Lord's house has many rooms. Whether you're a Rockefeller type with lots of money or whether you're an inexpensive, humble human being who is just barely getting by, God is always available to you, but you have to be willing to submit. And if you're not willing to submit to the Lord, why should he help you? He might allow you to have what you think is the best relationship on the planet for a few weeks' time, and then you discover after you're in it that it's really not right for you. The best way to tell whether or not someone is right for you is based on how they feel, on the one hand, how they think on the other hand, but also how they touch and what they smell like, what they taste like, and everything else that's a part of an intimate relationship. God gives you those gifts to utilize to know who is right for you, who is wrong for you, and what is due for you. What is due for you might be some more lessons of life because you have still not grown up in life. You are still struggling. You are still dealing with things. You are still unkind. You are still ugly in your soul. You're still harming people. You're still alarming people. You're still needing people in a way that's immoral. I often see women in this community who come from impoverished mindset or are literally on drugs in the city, and it makes me sad for them. But what's sad about them is that they're always trying to play up to a man to do something for them without ever asking whether or not they need a helping hand. You see, if someone would ask me what do I need, I could tell them the exact list on my priority list of what I need based on how I live my life every day. But most people don't do that. They try to presume themselves to be Lord in some way, and that they somehow are mind readers, or they just don't want to give me a say. Because if I gave them a say, or if they gave me a say, I'd tell them how their money could be invested in a different way. I tell them how that they could participate in something that is not wrong for me and more right for me in every way. The liars of America always walk out of the retail shops exactly as I sit down because they're going to play a game on an old man's life, and they're thinking they're not going to prison for that. It's stalking, it's mobbing, and it is cybercrime, but when do they ever stop?